Hello there, guys. This is the Brave Hylian, back here with more Let's Play Donkey Kong Country. Last time, we beat World 2 and got all the secrets there, so now we're gonna move on to World 3. Let's go. It's a nice twilighty atmosphere for this world, and you got a lot of forests in the first half of this World 3 here level. This is sort of the halfway point of the game. There are six worlds in Donkey Kong Country, plus a final boss, so I'm thinking that it's going to be seven videos, but if we get to be too time-consuming in the later worlds, we'll just have to see what we can do about that. So yeah, I got the secret level with the letters rotating. I don't really care about that. And I know I said it last time, but this world is where the shit kind of starts to hit the fan in terms of enemies and their placement. Like on that jump right there is really hard because you have to actually pull back on the control stick or you're gonna fly into the pit. And these vultures will spit all kinds of nuts and shit at you, and it's just no good at all. And I don't care about beating a secret level. Hit some vultures, and hey, we're already halfway through the level. What do you say? Oh man. So, yeah, like I said, it's been a nice, lazy day here so far, my day off of work. It is February 22nd here, I think, so I'm pretty sure I'm going to record all of this LP on the same day, which, as you know, does not usually make for a great quality of a video, at least for me, but, yeah, I just really wanted to play this game, and I thought, why not record it for you, ugly people? It'll be a fun time, so yeah. And that secret level can be a little hard to get because sometimes what'll happen is you'll hit the barrel when you're not actually on the platform, when you're still behind it, and then if you reveal a secret area on this game and then scroll off of that part of the screen, it'll go away, so you're gonna be up shit creek without a paddle if you do that in this level. You're gonna have to play it again. It's just no fun, because there's one thing in this game that's not recommended. It's going back and doing a whole level over again just so you can get the secret. It's just not fun. I like moving from level to level. This level, that secret area, took me a while to figure out how to get to. Because you know, there's no way to jump that high unless you have that gopher there. And even when it's there, sometimes it can be hard to get the timing down right, but no big deal, no big deal. This level's got more barrel cannon crap, so it can get a little tricky in this level. I must say, this is the first level where it sort of starts to get, not that you know, the other level is particularly easy. I mean, for me, in World 1 of a game like this, that's really, you know, not supposed to be that difficult. I mean, this game was made for kids, obviously. That barrel cannon canyon level in World 1 can be a little nasty, I'm not gonna lie. Me and Cassie were actually playing this game the other day, and she got to that level, and it's difficult, and you know, if you don't get the timing exactly right, you're gonna die. And to be fair, that is one of the things that I really like about this game, is that it does the physics so very well. Even though, you know, obviously it's not real, nothing like this would ever happen, but you do go down when you shoot out of a barrel, so just remember that when you're trying to do these levels. But you know, no big deal. Well, that was stupid. I feel like I ran over him there, but maybe not. Shoot. Oh, I did not even think about doing that. I'm really lucky there that I actually was able to do that. So this part can be a little confusing, but it's easy enough. There we go. I'm gonna skip the espresso token because I don't give a crap about that. Yeah, it is funny. In speedruns, those are actually not a good thing to get at all, because all they really do is, that's just basically a mini game where you get more lives. I might end up showing one of those just to show you guys what it's all about, but basically, shoot, no, oh, crap. This stupid controller, frick. Basically, I'm using a controller that's a lot like a PS2 controller, so it has a joystick where the control pad would usually be, so because of the way I was pressing the button with my thumb, I ended up ducking instead of moving to the right there. Oh my gosh, burping, sorry. Anyway, like I was saying, when you get those tokens, you basically get a mini game where you become those characters and you collect tiny little nanner like things to get lives, and all it really does is, like I said, get you extra lives. So if you're trying to do a speedrun and you don't really need the extra lives, it's pretty annoying to get three of those. And I've had times where I was trying to do a speedrun and I accidentally picked up that third espresso token or whatever it was and expressed a lot of anger in an oral fashion. It was not good. This level can be a little annoying, I must say. I was never a big fan of this level when I was a kid. Now it's kind of fun because it's a little different. You're not just plowing through the level, jump and shoot, man. But no, it's you actually have to be patient, and it's a different kind of platforming. It's kind of fun. They did stuff like this with Super Mario World as well, with the buzzsaws and all that, and the thing in Ludwig's Castle where you have to stay on the little platform while it goes all crazy and everything. But I like it. I like the premise of this level. It's they did a lot of stuff with it. Like right here, the G is here, and then there's going to be an extra life that you can get by going really fast. So it's cool. I like it. It can be a little annoying, but overall it's pretty fun. There's a secret level right there that's really easy to miss if you're not paying attention. So like right here with this Rambi token, I'm going to try and not get it right. I know it's not this one, so I'm going to pick that. There we go. And Rambi's extra level in particular is really, really pretty difficult. Let me get some tea here. Delicious. If you guys don't know about it, I absolutely recommend Arnold Palmer half iced tea, half lemonade from, I don't even know what tea company actually makes that. Is it Arizona? I'm not even sure. Either way, it's called Arnold Palmer, it's delicious, and you should go out and get some. Awesome. And that secret level right there can be a pain in the ass to get to, because if you accidentally hit one of those guys with your barrel, it's it's not good, because you'll lose your barrel and you'll have to go do that entire level again, get all the way back to that point to do that secret area, and it's a pain in the tuchus, if you ask me. Now, with this barrel, you want to take it and not hit that beaver with it and get to this part. And you can actually get extra lives if you hit enough enemies in this, like so. I think we picked up a couple, three extra lives there, so. Espresso is a little awkward with his controls. I'm not sure if we've used Espresso yet, but anyway, this is an ostrich. His name is Espresso. You start to see him a lot in this world, and his controls can be a little awkward, especially sometimes when you don't think you have the height for a jump. What you can actually do, when he flies for the first time, he like gets a little bit of a boost, so you can use that. Obviously, his gliding ability is very nice, especially in certain levels. There's an ice level later in the game that you need Espresso to get a secret level on, but I'll talk about that more when I get there. To be honest, I've never really had much of a use for him in this level, but we're doing pretty well here now. I mean, he can be useful. I mean, obviously, I haven't really demonstrated this, but Espresso is very, very quick. So on this stretch, he's particularly useful because you're just trying to sort of get away from, you know, that one part. This part, I don't think he's going to make it. Yeah, I didn't think that was going to happen, but yeah, Espresso definitely has its uses, and since you can't carry over the animal buddies between levels like you could with Yoshi in Super Mario Brothers, it's okay that you get hit with him. He's kind of an extra hit. Anyway, this level, Orangutan Gang, is one of the most annoying levels in the game, mostly because there are five secret levels in this particular stage. And you need Espresso to get pretty much all of them, so it's tough, I'm not gonna lie. It's not exactly the best level in the world. What I'm gonna do first is actually get the halfway barrel, I think, because the first thing we're gonna do here is we're gonna take Espresso and fly as far as we can, and then we're gonna go get a a secret that is way back at the beginning of the stage. So what you want to do is you want to get on this platform here that you were on right at the beginning and jump and float, and all the way over at the very, very beginning of the level, right beneath it, there's a secret over here. And it's one of these. I don't care for it, so I'm just gonna, you know, pass it on. Now, the annoying thing about this level is that it dumps you out here. Here, there we go. And we are already very far past another secret area in the game. So what I'm going to do, actually, is I'm going to die. I'm going to die by jumping off the edge. If there was an edge to jump off of, that would be great. No, there's not. There's not an edge to jump off of. This is not good. Okay, well, I'm going to go ahead and get a couple other secrets before I... Because, see, there's one back... We skipped pretty much halfway through this level, almost. Probably more than that. I mean, we're right here at the end. But there's a secret near, closer to the middle that we need to go get, and we need Espresso to do it. So that's why I died, because I wanted to, or I wanted to die, but I actually didn't, because I wanted to go back to the halfway barrel so we could go ahead and get the secret in the middle of the level. But what I might do is just finish the level and then go back later to get it. Why is he not throwing the barrels? Okay, this one is pretty tricky to get. What you have to do here is you have to time this exactly right, jump over the barrels, kill Monkey Kong, and then follow the barrel here, and then get in there. Very good. It's really easy to lose that barrel, and if you let it off your out of your sights, you are screwed, and you gotta do the whole level again. And it still dump us off right here. I'm gonna go ahead and finish the level just because... We still have one to get there. As you can see, the exclamation mark is not next to Orangutan Gang yet, indicating that I have not yet gotten all the secrets in this level. So let's go back in there and finish it off. And this is a thing you can do. You can throw these steel barrels and ride them. It's pretty useful in this level, and then there's a level later in the game I know where you definitely need to do it. So, whoa! Meant to jump off that thing sooner, but... And here we are back here in this level again. This level actually has a pretty cool atmosphere for being so annoying, with the whole sunset thing going on in the background. And I don't know. This level would be a lot of fun, I feel like, if you didn't have to get so many damn secrets in it. Just watch out for the barrels that Mankey throws there. It's just pretty annoying to have to deal with that, especially with Espresso, because you need him to get this secret and a couple of the others. So. Just, you know, do your best to avoid them. The timing is really not that hard to work out, but easy for me to say, right? I've been playing this game forever. So here we are in Clam City. It's another underwater level. These levels I like to use Donkey Kong on because there's no difference in the controls, and if I lose Donkey Kong by getting hit by a stupid thing, it's not a big deal. Here's where Engarde is in this level. He is actually in every single water level in the game, all... four of them, I believe. So make sure to pick him up, because not only is he fast and kills enemies, he's also an extra hit, so you don't lose one of your Kongs in the process of trying to beat the level. So Engarde is definitely a very useful character to use, faux show. Okay, kill the shark. Eileen would not be happy with me. My sister is very interested, and she loves sharks, so sorry, Eileen, that I'm killing your shark friends. We like to go to the aquarium and see the sharks in the water there. It's really nice. The aquarium is probably easily one of my favorite day trip destinations, and since we're on a water level, it seems appropriate to mention that. Personally, I'm not a huge fan of the sharks so much as I am the they have otters there. The otters are pretty awesome, and I also pretty big fan of the penguins, although those are always really popular with the smaller kids, so you don't always get to enjoy them quite as much as you would. But yeah, they have skate there. They have, you know, they have a big freaking crocodile there. That's pretty cool. So, oh, and this is the boss where I get to say a bee. Sorry, NCS. Yeah, but, this boss can be pretty annoying, because sometimes It can move in ways that you don't expect, and the barrel, sometimes you can, drop it or hitting the bee when it's red like that is usually your biggest concern. That's something you definitely don't want to do. So, that being said, this is probably the hardest boss in the game besides the final boss, and it's still pretty easy. So, there you have it, guys. World 3. It's got a lot of secrets. It's a little bit tougher, but we got through it. And next time here on Let's Play Donkey Kong Country, we will move on to World 4 Gorilla Glacier. This is the Brave Hylian signing off for now. Thank you guys so much for tuning in today, and I will see you later. Bye now.